Thus Murphy, being chased across the moon by a known felon. In order for me to tell you the whole story, though, and it's a long one, we're going to have to go back to the beginning, a bounty hunting mission with my old friend Brusjef.
Chase him down. Oh, he's hurting.
Now, I should take a moment to point out that although he was a hardened criminal, the guy that we just blew up is not going to be the one causing Murphy a problem later.
Yeah, I'm still trying to dial in the sensitivity of the joystick as well. My game's not great yet. Oh, really? Huh. Maybe I'll have to try that. I'll give it a bit and see if it loosens up, and if not, then I'll...
Okay,
you've
come out a bit.
Low-grav coffee.
Well, actually, I don't know how many of my Elite Dangerous stories that you read, but you probably heard about the Hutton mug, right? That the coffee mug has because of this. It can actually hold another metric ton of coffee. It compresses all that coffee into this orange sludge that you just drink the liquid off the top of.
So you can have almost infinite coffee?
A bottomless cup of coffee, pretty much. And because of all that compression, the coffee is always hot.
That's amazing. That sounds like a magic item that I would want.
The only problem is that if you forget to secure the mug before you go into free flight mode and it turns off your gravity, oh boy, that mug is going to be flying all over the ship. Like a fucking cannonball. So Commander Wingnut at one point flew out of Thargoid and rammed into it. The coffee mug went flying out of the canopy and punched the Thargoid in the face. The first man ever recorded in history to literally mug an alien life form.
Amazing.
You want to do a desert planet or something like that? I want to go for a buzz.
Sure, sounds fun.
Yeah, Murphy was originally, I had visions of her being a racer, but I figured I'd have a lot to learn before I'm ready for that.
Yeah, he looked pretty shady, but it wasn't that guy either.
Like, imagine like a billion Bill Gates, and that's apparently Archibald Hurston. I can't even fathom that. Hell, I have a hard enough time trying to fathom $1 billion.
We've got Bezos approaching $1 trillion, and that just blows my mind.
Yeah.
I can't comprehend what one would do with $1 trillion.
I've tried to explain this to my dad, how a billionaire just isn't natural as far as economy goes. I've tried to explain to him, okay.
Oh, you've got no helmet on. Run! Can I drop a med pen, maybe? I do have one on me. No, I don't seem to be able to drop them. They're just kind of in my inventory.
Well, according to my vitals, I'm still looking blue. I'm about 66%, so it should be good. If anything's going to kill us, it's probably not going to be it.
No, I can't stab you with it, unfortunately. Well, I hope that you don't die.
Well, you can throw it out on the floor or the pad.
Oh, wait, I should try that. Hang on. That looks like a med pen to me. Let's drop that. Damn it. Let's try again. Okay, I'm going to place it right on this red strip.
Okay.
Did it disappear?
I think it did.
Yep. Maybe we should try this in the ship.
Basically, we're being followed around by an invisible Chris Roberts who snatches up everything we put down. You ever wonder why the shopkeeper's always complaining that he has to pick up after you? That's Chris Roberts in disguise.
It's a Roberts world out there.
Yep. It's a robber's world, but we're all just living in it. Why is the elevator not coming down?
I don't know. Oh, there we go.
Well, don't stand you under it, you fool. Murphy's Law can't protect you from stupid.
We'll see about that.
Well, yeah. Welcome aboard to Quarrelsome Goose.
Thank you for having me on board.
You are clear to launch.
Roger that. Launch clearance received. We are good to go.
Take off, please. Mission alert.
V1, rotate.
V2, rotate.
I still have that funky glow.
We still got that? Oh,
yeah.
Wow. I hope it's not St. Elmo's Lightning.
You should change the name of the ship to the Shrouded Goose.
Or the Nebulous Hulk.